Hi there, and thank you for joining us here on the web. I'm Erin Fehlau. 4 days after she vanished, the search for Selena Cass is intensifying, with dozens of specially trained law enforcement officials hitting the ground. They started from near her West Stewartston home this morning and fanned out on foot, covering a one-mile area. They're also using helicopters again, and they're searching local ponds and streams for any sign of the 11-year-old. Ray Brewer reports on the latest developments.
Around 8 o'clock Friday morning, searchers gathered a couple of hundred feet from Selena Cass's home to begin another day of looking for the 11-year-old girl. Cass was last seen Monday night at her house. Since then, there has been no trace of her.
I'll be basically in the ditch.
New Hampshire Fish and Game and trained volunteers fanned out searching the area in a one-mile radius from the girl's home. It's ground they've covered before, but they want to make sure they haven't missed anything.
We're looking for any clues, any disturbed ground, anything that will aid us in our search to bring her home.
That included using a helicopter to search from above and boats to cover the many ponds and lakes in the area. This is the fourth day since Cass disappeared, and it seems to have upset everyone around here, including neighboring Vermont. Paul Cody has two posters of Cass on the window of his garage.
It's a child. It's a young girl. It shouldn't happen to people. It shouldn't happen to kids. Things like that don't happen around here. I mean, it's devastating to the family and a lot of the people.
Including Kevin Eldred. He says on Tuesday he saw dog teams in the area.
And they turned around and came down the main road, right back out of town.
And he says the longer this goes on without any resolution or hints of what may have happened, the more it affects people.
People are locking their doors. They usually don't lock the doors. Have some elderly neighbors that I talked to last night that said they're glad that I'm next door, you know, and it just makes people afraid.
So let's recap the timeline of the case before today. Police say Selena was last seen at a home computer Monday night. Tuesday morning, her stepfather found her room empty. She had disappeared without a trace. By Tuesday afternoon, New Hampshire Fish and Game had started an air and ground search. Wednesday, they were joined by the Attorney General's office and a special team from the FBI. Yesterday, the State Police Major Crimes Unit arrived at Selena's home. Authorities also announced that they were following more than 150 tips that had come in so far. And of course, you can follow this story every hour of the day by logging on to our website. Our reporters in the field are sending back live updates along with video and images of the search. And you will find current pictures also of Selena. A Massachusetts police officer who drowned last weekend in the Merrimack River is being laid to rest in New Hampshire today. 30-year-old Charles P.J. Panic graduated from Pelham High School in 1999. He spent time in the Marines before joining the force in Lowell. You can see his colleagues lined up this morning to pay their respects at his funeral at St. Patrick's Church in Pelham. Panic was on a boat with friends last week when he jumped overboard to go swimming, and he never resurfaced. Well, starting tonight at 5, from the ground, the air, on the water, we'll have team coverage of the search for Selena. And that does it for this webcast. Thanks for joining us, and have a great weekend.